One of the showpieces on the ramp at the Reno Air Races is the National Aviation Heritage Invitational. Just east of the grandstands, you'll find a collection of beautifully restored aircraft. It's a flying museum whose collection of planes changes every year. As we prepare for the National Championship Air Races and the Heritage Invitational, we take a look at one of the award-winning planes from 2010. The Howard Hughes Trophy winner for large aircraft is the DC-2, owned by Clay Lacy. This is the only DC-2 flying in the world, and we talked with Clay for a few minutes inside the plane.
The DC-2 first came out in 1934, I think, December. This one was built in March of 1935.
That's only 31 years after the Wright brothers made their first flight, and the DC-2 was about to launch the airline industry.
I think the general opinion is the DC-2 and the DC-3 made the airlines. It was the first airplane you could really fly comfortably in, had heat and was quiet. They give C.R. Smith, the chairman of American Credit, for going to Douglas and saying, why don't you push the sides out and get another row of seats in here? And that made the DC-3. In fact, in 1937, I believe both United and American, I know United had it, service from New York, leave at 8 o'clock at night. And two flights, one would arrive in San Francisco and one in Los Angeles, 8 o'clock in the morning. So they advertised, leave at 8, arrive at 8. And of course, with 3 hours time difference, it's 15 hours. But four stops. I mean, it really changed the world. Now, this particular airplane is painted TWA because they were the first airline to order them. This airplane was ordered new by Pan American. And Pan American then sent it down to South America for their South American division, Pan Angra. The first time I personally ever saw this airplane was about 1958 at McCall, Idaho. Johnson Flying Service owned it, and they were using it for smoke jumper training and for jumping smoke, dropping smoke jumpers.
After several years of sitting idle, it was given to the Douglas Historical Society, who did some restoration and then flew promotional flights.
And then about the time Douglas and Boeing went together, the airplane was sitting there. And a good friend of mine, Bruce McCaw from Seattle, he bought it to give it to the museum in Seattle. But it needed a lot of work. So we said, we'll fix it up, put an A1 condition flyable. And everything is new in here. As you see, all the upholstery, and we put new floorboards or plywood in here, and the engine's been recently overhauled, only 40 hours flying at this point.
Clay Lacy has flown just about every kind of aircraft ever built. And if you've seen a movie or television show that had flying in it, chances are Clay Lacy was at the controls of the plane shooting the scene. He was instrumental in developing the Astrovision system of aerial photography. So what does he think about how the DC-2 flies?
Kind of flies like a Taylor craft or a J3 cab. It's lighter than a DC-3 and it just wants to jump in the air, you know. It'll take off at 65 and just wants to climb and come and land at 65.
In 2010, Clay was enshrined in the National Aviation Hall of Fame, an honor well-deserved for his skill in aviation and service to the industry. Live Air Show TV was on hand to broadcast the ceremony in Dayton, Ohio. You can see Clay's complete acceptance speech on the Live Air Show TV YouTube channel. With all the honors and accolades he's received, don't look for him to slow down anytime soon. You can tell this is a special plane in his collection. It's a wonderful example of an early air transport.
So, this is it. I'm glad this is flying.
So are we, Clay. To learn more about the National Aviation Heritage Invitational, go to heritagetrophy.com and follow us on our Facebook page. From the 2010 Reno National Championship Air Races and the National Aviation Heritage Invitational, I'm Jeff Lee, Live Air Show TV.